Mary Ann Hansen. I'm an extension plant pathologist with Virginia Cooperative Extension, and I work in the Virginia Tech Plant Disease Clinic, where we received a sample of late blight on tomato recently, and we've received several samples of this disease. And this is a disease that's caused by a pathogen called a water mold. It's a fungus-like organism. It's called a water mold because it produces swimming spores that like really wet conditions. So we typically see this disease when temperatures are pretty mild and there's a lot of cloudy weather, wet, rainy weather, then this pathogen can get around and the conditions favor infection. And what you'll see with late blight is these brown lesions on the leaves, and you can get similar lesions on the stems. You can get spots on the fruit. Often the fruit spots will come in from the stem end and you'll get these large brown areas on the fruit, or you can see the lesions on basically any plant part. Here you see it on just the middle of the fruit, and it's kind of a black, dark, greasy looking spot, similar to the spots that you see on the leaves. As those leaf spots enlarge, they will blight whole leaves, and this pathogen quickly will blight the entire plant, and that entire plant can be wiped out in a very short period of time. This disease moves so rapidly that it can literally wipe out a field overnight. And that's what we saw with the sample that we received in the clinic from a grower in Wythe County. He said that he had 650 plants, three different varieties. They were all wiped out within a matter of days in his field. And that's what late blight can do. In fact, this is the same disease that caused the Irish potato famine in the mid-19th century, where many of the Irish starved because they lost their entire potato crop during a two-week period of very wet, rainy weather. So this is a pathogen that can attack both potato and tomato. It is what's called an obligate parasite, so it needs living tissue to survive. So it's not going to survive on dead tissue, it's not going to survive in the absence of living tissue. And that means that if you've had your tomato field or garden wiped out by late blight, the pathogen will not overwinter on that dead crop debris. And that's a good thing for tomato growers. The bad thing for potato growers is that if it's in the tubers, which it can be, then it could survive in potato tubers that you keep over the winter. So you want to make sure you don't keep any living tissue of either potato or tomato around that could harbor the pathogen. And another place where you might have that is if you have a greenhouse with some tomato transplants. So you want to make sure you don't have the pathogen surviving there. Other ways to control the disease include resistant varieties, and there are several late blight resistant varieties of tomato. And you can also use fungicides to control the disease, but you have to do that preventatively. So you need to have a fungicide in place protecting those plants before you have these conditions of prolonged, wet, rainy, cool weather. So keep an eye on the weather predictions and make sure you have an appropriate fungicide in place, and you should be able to prevent this disease on your tomatoes and potatoes.